I think I'm live. I haven't done this in a little while, so bear with me here. In fact, as usual, please send me a little comment. Tell me that you see me and you hear me. I'll take a little sip of this nice hot mulled wine. I'm Tony Furtado. I'll be your host tonight. Live from Squirrelville. Oh, the heater's going up. I do not need the heater, even though it's cold as heck. Here, we don't need that sound going off. Hi, Gail. How you doing? So, you see me. Can you hear me? Hi, Angela. Good to see ya. Oh, that hits the spot. I'm gonna start with something on the guitar. I'm here to play some songs, answer some questions, if you got any, or play some requests, or just chit chat. Hi, Mom. I'm late. 5 minutes late, yes. Thanks. Hey, Ashlyn, how you doing? Sounds good. Nice to see you. Okay, good. Glad you can hear. My Way Moody. Hello from Chesapeake, Virginia. Looking forward to the music. All right. Must be about 10:05 over there. Just a hair. There we go, right there. Tearing up the track. no more. He'll pour the bow to the steely bed. His race has run its final lap, but his soul will never quit. He outstrips wind with lightning speed, tearing up the track. He's broken free, a man of war. He's never looking back. He's never looking back. Yeah, when I smile, it's usually when I'm either forgetting words or making a little mistake. But that was fun. Stephanie, yes, turtleneck Tony, yeah. You like that? I feel like I look like, well, I don't look like Alan Alda, but I seem to recall him wearing a turtleneck in some made-for-TV movie years ago, and for some reason my mind goes to the 70s. Hey there, love that song, Broken Bell. Thought it was about a broken bell, beautiful, and the hammer was a symbol for a man, masculinity. I was surprised when you said it was about the music industry. You know, you gotta leave songs open to interpretation. So, you hear it the way you hear it, and I know the way I wrote it. But I love that you heard it a different way. That's killer. What kind of guitar is that? Well, this here is an old Martin guitar. It's an 017 from 1944. See Martin right there. I got this in the 90s at a shop in Salt Lake City called Intermountain Music. And I remember the two owners were Leonard and Kennard. And I don't know if they're still there, but I remember they had one guitar like this in the window. And I seem to recall seeing a picture of Ry Cooder playing a guitar that looked just like it. And I was like, I gotta try that guitar. Maybe I'll play that good. So went in there, picked up the guitar, started playing it. And either Leonard or Kennard came back with a few more of them, just like that. And then a few more, because he had like copious amounts of these guitars back then, because no one wanted them yet. And then he said, okay, you like those? Now try this one. And I was hooked. Lined and sinkered, so I got it, and it was mint condition, nearly mint condition, so I put every crack in that sucker on there. Hey Tony, hey, how's it going, Tina? So glad you're playing tonight. This is from Maplewood. How about I wait for this? Aw, sure, I could probably do that, maybe do that a little later. Andy Plymail, good to see you out there. Maybe I'll just dive into something else here. It's pretty cold here in Portland. Like, it got really cold really quick. That's why I'm drinking my mulled wine. Adding to the 70s vibe. For some reason, I feel like mulled wine is the 70s thing too. I don't know. Voting in. I can't say I hope you all got your way, but I don't think anyone got their complete way on this. It's just one of those things. I'm not going to get into politics. Let's just, not right now. The 70s rocked. Yes, they did. All right. Thank you. to waste your life if you don't. I used to be a gold and the stones and the rocks. I used to be jealous, but I used it all up. I don't know when it ever felt so good to be standing in the rain. I don't know when it ever felt so good to be standing in the rain. The ground is wet and so's your hair. Go ahead and take me, I'll go anywhere. There's nothing that I'm wanting, let's go take a swim. We'll find out where the story in the stream began. I don't know when it ever felt so good to be standing in the rain. I don't know when it ever felt so good to be standing in the rain. I don't know when it ever felt so right. Not when the sun was shining big and bright. I don't know when it ever felt so good to be standing in the rain. I don't know when it ever felt so good to be standing in the rain. I don't know. So good, be standing in the rain. I don't know when it ever felt so good, be standing in the rain.
Just felt right to do that one, even though it's not raining today. It's been raining like crazy over here. I wrote that song a long time ago when I first moved to Portland, a little over 20 years ago, I think. 2002, I moved here. And I wrote it with a guy named Jules Scheer. You guys remember Jules Scheer, Jules and the Polar Bears? He was also the host of MTV Unplugged when they had a host. They had a host on MTV Unplugged for a little while, like 14 episodes, and he was kind of wacky. He played the guitar upside down and fretted it with his thumb and everything. I'm going to play one of these banjos here. Tina. Yeah, okay, cool. I thought you might know that song too, yeah. Andy Plymail. Good to see you, buddy. Did I already say hey to you? I can't remember. Brain going. God, I've been watching this. I got stuck into a show. You know how you start a show and you figure, oh, this will be good. I'll binge watch this for a while. So I'm a real sci-fi nut. I love sci-fi movies and shows and stuff. And I've always loved, you know, the concept of the War of the Worlds. You know, that they went through the two old movies, the really old movie, and then the newer movie with Tom Cruise, and that was kind of freaky and bloody and weird. But then they had 3-episode miniseries that happened, I guess, a couple years ago. I thought that was kind of interesting, set like 100-some-odd years ago. But then the newest one, I guess it was a series for about 3 years, War of the Worlds, and like Britain in English and French, set in Britain. And, you know, kind of got into it at first. And then I don't know. I don't think it was very good, but I got sucked in for 3 full seasons. And I just kind of binged it a little bit, and I couldn't wait for the end of it to come. Anyone ever seen that one? Are there any nerds out there? Okay, no one's answering. You probably guys think I'm a total dork. I'm a dork. Look, I play the banjo, so... Hey, Paula, how you doing? Good to see you.
I need another sip of the mulled wine here.
Hey Charlie, how you doing? How was the Midwest Great Lakes region tour?
It was good. I enjoyed it.
Gail, not a dork. I would look out for that, of course. I'm not one to be talking as I play the banjo. So, yeah, sci-fi. I play the banjo. I do ceramics. Total dork. Banjo, I just feel like doing that one right now. Any banjo players out there want to learn any of those tunes from Decembering, the new banjo album? I never talk about this, but I actually made a whole book with all of those tunes as well as some others that I've been meaning to tab out. And but I'm only offering it digitally, and I've been really bad about like making it obvious on my website, but it's there, and it's on something called payhip.com. Payhip, P-A-Y-H-I-P, payhip.com. And just look me up. So, it's the banjo book number 3 for all you banjo dorks like me. So this one's called Greenheart.
Thank you.
Good to see you. Thanks, Gail. It was good to see you, Jody, a short while ago at Stephanie's birthday. Glad you guys came over. Any questions? Any comments? I mean, not comments. Requests. You're making plenty of comments here. Thank you so much. I'd like to take just a second and advertise a couple things I got coming on, if you guys don't mind. If there's anyone near near enough Portland, or if you know anyone near Portland, first of all, I've got my annual Thanksgiving show, or post-Thanksgiving show, that I do every year at Mississippi Studios. In fact, here is the little poster. That's not really a poster. It's just giving you the details. As you'll notice, it's got Jake Jolliffe, Luke Price, Stephanie Schneider, and Keith Brush to be in my acoustic band, as well as Hans Araki will be in playing with me on that. And then starting off the whole thing will be Hans Araki and Colleen Rainey with their buddy and our buddy, everybody's buddy, Carrie Novotny. I have some other special guests joining us as well, just like usual. There are some tickets left. It is a seated show, so there's not as many tickets. So please get those tickets ASAP. Let us know you're coming. That's going to be a blast. I would also like to tell you, for years we did an annual holiday party at the Falcon Community Arts over there, Albina, North Albina and Killingsworth, down in the basement of the Falcon building. There's 26 studios, a bunch of artists and musicians, myself included, as well as X-Ray Radio is based down there. It's a big, fun group of folks down there. And usually we would do the thing every holiday, but, you know, obviously, for obvious reasons, we haven't done it for a few years, like 3 years, I think. Crazy. So we're doing it December 1st, and this is what that poster looks like. Right there. You are all invited. Come one, come all. If you're from out of town, make your way over. Or if you got friends here, like I said before, you know, tell your friends. Would be great to see you. Show you what I've been doing in my studio. I've got a bunch of new pieces, as well as I always do a couple of sets, and hopefully Stephanie will join me on those couple sets. I usually do like 7 o'clock acoustic set and an 8 o'clock set. And that's all the advertising I need to do right now. I will throw this up here for a minute. This little... Is it around? No. I usually have a little... Oh, I know what's wrong. Throw me a couple of... requests, please. And I'll tell you if I can... do it. Move to the top. There it is. Just that little annoying thing that I put up sometimes. Let me make it a little bit bigger just for now. And then I'll get rid of it. Coming back here. Hey Debbie, how you doing? Good to see you. Alright, well I got the regular banjo here. This out to Tina, because I wrote this for Tina and Pete, my friends over in Maplewood, New Jersey. It's called Tina and Pete. It's off of the newest banjo album, Decembering. And I'm also going to follow that with my very first tune I think I ever wrote, that I call The Road to Donegal. I had never even been to Ireland, but I saw some cool postcard that had this road that was going to Donegal, and it just looked like an amazing road, so... There you go, The Road to Donegal. Okay. Thank you. like I needed to pep it up a little bit. So I put in another one of my tunes called Icebound, which of course is fitting for this weather we're having over here. It's supposed to get really cold here in Portland next week, from what I understand. Like, maybe we'll get snow? I don't know. Near the creaking upstairs. How we doing for requests? Anything? Hey, Francine, you were thrilled to hear me in April when I came to Castoro Cellars in San Luis Obispo with Luke Price. Yes, that was fun. I love playing there. For the Slow Folk Association folks. Slapped my hat doing a... Oh. Tom Arnold, I don't know what you're saying. You slapped something doing a jig. running down a dream. Andy, yeah, coming down with the big gun. All right, I could do that if I remember the words. That'd be fun. Yeah, hey, let me take this annoying thing off the screen, please. I get a little self-conscious with this thing up there. Bam. Good. All right. Oh, you know what? I got a request for you guys. If you think of it, I don't know how many of you are Twitch users, but I've been streaming to Twitch these past bunch of times that I stream. Just kind of getting my feet wet over there. And I don't have a lot of followers yet, like 22 or something. I think once you get to a certain amount of subscribers or followers, there's other things you can do on the page, like scheduling a certain way. So go on over to Twitch and subscribe to me over there too, if you don't mind. You can even watch it over there from Twitch right now, if you're Twitchable. I just want to do that when I say Twitch. Twitch. Okay. Thanks, Tina. It's not annoying when you ask for money. You should get money for your art. Okay, well, whatever. running down a dream, I do in F sharp. I actually recorded this song on a live album I did. I don't know how many years ago I released that album. Like 15, 16 years ago or something. Ancient history. 17 years ago? I don't know. It's called Bare Bones. I had to go around with a little interface and that hooked up to my computer and plugged in all the mics and stuff so I could record a bunch of live shows. Boy, was I bad at it. But luckily we got just enough... that worked out, that came out making an okay album. So, and this was one of those songs.
demise. The last 3 days, the rain was unstoppable. It was always cold, no sunshine.
Thanks for the request for that, Andy. Morgan. Hey, Morgan. How you doing? Just joined Portlandia. Hey. Wow. Cypress Grove, Raleigh and Spencer. Okay. Let me think about one of those. Debbie, mesmerizing and wondering, how the heck does he do that? I don't know. It's the mulled wine. Things in tune. Hey, let's check out the, let's see if the dobro banjo is in tune. It's on the wall here. Oh boy. You guys ever seen one of these? Oh, yeah, it's not in tune. Do I dare? I dare. Thank you. cartoon thing or the running down a dream. So this is Dobro Banjo, and usually what I do when I pick this one up is a tune called Water Slide that I wrote that's on Roll My Blues Away. You're well. Hoping to get down your way maybe in the spring. We'll see. Okay, here's a little water slide. Stop the song, put the pick on. There's no surviving that. Hey, Bo, how you doing? Good to see you on here. Roll My Blues Away. Paul McCandless gave you that, huh? Oh, I wonder how that guy's doing. I haven't seen him in ages. For all of you who don't know who Paul is, he was a founding member of a band called Oregon. I had the honor, the extreme honor of getting to play with him for a couple of years, him playing in my band called the American Gypsies. Anyway, good to see you here, Bo. How about a happy song of some sort? Thanks, Brian. Oh, I could make you tired of me playing the banjo. He says, never gets old listening to you play the banjo. Okay, well, I appreciate you saying that. Song Bolinas was played at my wedding on piano, guitar, and tabas. Oh my god, you told me that. I would love to hear that. Well, you know what? Maybe instead of doing a songy song, I'll do one of my old songs that is pretty. It's a pretty song, but it's about a murderer. And I learned this one from listening to Taj Mahal, mainly. Speaking of Bolinas, for some reason, why am I tying Taj with Bolinas? Did he live in Mill Valley or something? Bo, you might know that. Didn't he live for a while up that way? Maybe not in Bolinas, but he Mill Valley, maybe? Still has a house there. I know he also lived in Hawaii and stuff, but anyway, this one. I learned this listening to him and Woody Guthrie and Mississippi John Hurt. It's called Staggerly.
Tell me, how can this be? You arrest everybody,
but go steadily, oh, the bad man grew steadily.
Played together. It's been a while. We got to do something together sometime again, Mary. How you doing? Good to see you here. when I first moved here, I think Mary had just moved here too. I can't remember. Maybe you've been here a few years already, but we did a couple things early on. I played some banjo on one of her albums. I remember that. That was fun. Anyway, yeah. Let's get together, do something, be fun. Hey, John, I saw the offer of the booking at Mishawaka next spring. Well, that's actually, it was for, I guess someone's going to be getting married there. So we chatted. Maybe it'll at least get me out there to do a couple other gigs that are public as well. We'll see. Anyway, good, all good there, Mary. Good to hear. So I think I'll just do one or two more here. Tina, you wanted to hear Bolinas, I bet. I'm a sucker to play that tune. That's a fun one to play. Any last requests or last comments, questions? I love chatting. It's a lot of fun to actually get a little interaction online. I just did that little tour recently. Hey, Ghost of Blind Willie Johnson would be fun, sure. Maybe I'll play it on the Kalamazoo. Let's see how that thing sounds right now. I haven't pulled this thing down for, I don't know, years. this is what this one looks like. I don't know when it was made, maybe the 20s or early 30s or something. I think it was tuned back then too, so. Mentions about the Mississippi Studio Show. If you guys are living in Portland, around Portland, or you got friends around here, I didn't even say, did I? It's November 25th. It's a Friday. It's the day after Thanksgiving at Mississippi Studios. My acoustic band is going to be Keith Brush on the bass, Luke Price on the fiddle, Jake Jolliffe on the mandolin. He's a world-renowned mandolinist, and he grew up around here, but he's living, I think, in Brooklyn. But he's going to be around, so I ringed him in to the band. Stephanie Schneiderman, my wonderful wife, who's around here somewhere, will be playing with us and singing with us. Hans Araki will be playing flute, and Hans and Colleen Rainey will be opening the show. They're almost freshly moved back from, they were living in Portland, Maine for a little while. I believe this is their first show back to the Pacific Northwest. And Kerry Novotny will be playing with them. So it's going to be a big old fun acoustic love fest up there. And hopefully some special guests as well as usual. So there's some tickets left. I think they're going kind of at a nice pace now. It's a fully seated show, so not a lot of tickets. Mary, this is a Kalamazoo. It's not a Gibson. Well, I guess, you know the deal with Kalamazoo. It's somehow partly made by Gibson, I guess, or something. There's a connection in there. Jody. Is that dobro banjo vintage? What era? Love that sound. The dobro banjo is not vintage. Depends on what vintage is. I went back and forth with them about an endorsement model, but then they went out of business, and that's what I got out of the deal. So I had them kind of refine when dobro was still together. I had them refine that about 30 years ago or something to where it is right now. Anyway. So this is going to be a tune called The Ghost of Blind Willie Johnson. I'll do a little bit of this and one other thing, and then we'll call it quits for tonight. This is named after one of my heroes of the slide, of the slide guitar, the great Blind Willie Johnson. I'm sure Mary can attest to the fact that Blind Willie Johnson was one of the absolute greats and one of the most influential slide guitarists of all time, like he was singing. Thank you. guitar. It's got so much punch. It's got so much something. You know what it's got a lot of? It's got a lot of Elmer's glue. Someone, sometime, fixed it with some funky glue. And I'm afraid to fix it, because it'll sound different, I guarantee it. Hey, it's been so awesome to have you guys listening, watching. Such a treat for me to be able to just do this at a moment's notice. I'm going to throw this up here one more time. And how come it didn't show up? Let me see here. Order, move to top. There it is. No biggie. Just throwing that up. Stay tuned. Hopefully I'll find a time to do another one of these with Luke Price when he gets back from his trip from New York City. And I'm looking forward to the show November 25th at Mississippi Studios, and then the Falcon Art thing that we're going to be doing on December 1st. I don't usually do two instrumentals in a row, but what the hell? Tina requested Bolinas. I feel like doing it. Did I talk about enough stuff? I think I did. All I can say is thank you all for tuning in. And if you're feeling it all tipsy, I put the link up there. Keep in touch. Here's a little Bolinas. Thank you. Tony signing out. See you next time.